Hello everyone, in this tutorial we are going to learn how to turn teeth into teeth with Blender. Let's start with the tutorial. You will need Blender and a file called Edgenode, to which I will leave a link in the description. If you don't know how to use Blender, I encourage you to go and check this tutorial that will appear in the corner of this video. So, before we start with the magic, we actually need to make some changes in the render properties tab. So first, let's go to sampling and let's put it down to 1. This will get rid of anti-aliasing and some soft shadows that occur while rendering. Then let's turn on ambient occlusion, skin space reflection if you want to, and most importantly, foam, both to transparent. This will leave a transparent background, and this is one of the most important steps, that is to change the view look to filmic to standard. Also, we are going to need to turn on the normal path in the view layer properties. So go to view layer properties, you will find passes, close, open it. And inside data, you click on normal. This is one of the most important steps. Make sure you do not miss this one or it will not work. So, once we have all this set, let's go to the... So, now let's go to the compositing screen. Make sure to check use nodes. And you will find something like this. If you click render with F12, you will see basically nothing changed. This is the place where we are going to do the magic, if you want to call it like that. So let's start with first appending the edge node. So we go to downloads, look for the file, it should be called edge node. Inside of it, look for node tree, and you will find this, which has this picture on the file. Append it, and now we are going to add it, pressing Shift A, search, and edge node, this one. We will have to make some modification to this node by first entering on it with tab, and then look for this node right here. It looks complicated, but you don't need to know what happened inside of the node. Just look at this, which says x2, then clamp. Take this value and drop it in an empty node, in an empty point, just at the input right here. That's the only modification we're going to do in this node. Now, add the depth to the set in. Add the normal to the normal. Now, if you put the edge out in the composite, you will see that it is inverted. So to solve this, we're going to Shift A, search, and invert. And now we'll have a more normal looking image. So now reduce the normal enhancement to almost 0, or a little bit more if you please, and you notice it extracts the edges from the image. So this is the most easy part, and the reason I made you put the value in the input is because we're going to take the image, first your color ramp, and I will explain you what I'm doing in a moment. Take the image to the color ramp, and from the color ramp to the value, to the value input. Now what does this do? First invert it, take this little node and invert it. And what this is doing, it is subtracting the lines from when the light is. If you notice the image, you will see that where the light is, the lines can be seen. And if you want to imitate this, then this is how we do it. So now, again, into the composite, you see where the light is, there are no lines. So this helps making it more aesthetically pleasing and more good looking in general. Now, a key component of the manga looking is the gray tones, right? So to do that, add a color ramp. And with this, we are going to create a tone map. This is a little bit more complex than getting the edge, but if you follow me, we'll be able to do it. So, get the color ramp. For now, we are going to get rid of the edges. And you see that it looks like a black and white image. This is not exactly what we want. So, change the interpolation method from linear to constant, and you see we get a more like crisp edges between tones. So in between black and white, add a second tone and put it on the grain and the gray values. Then in between this one, add another tone and make it a little bit more bright, and you will see that it starts looking like a proper manga. But if you have seen manga before, you will notice that gray tones are not made out of gray color, but out of dots, individual dots that make the illusion of gray. So how do we achieve this gray tone in here? It's quite easy. So first, we are going to turn this from a grayscale to an RGB scale. So black, we are going to turn black into red. We are going to turn the dark gray into green, eliminate all the blue. Turn the light gray into blue. And finally, the white, reduce all the colors and also this A, which means alpha. So that way we created this weird looking image that is going to be really useful to separate the screen tones. I will show you how. First, add an RGB, separate RGBA, and you will see that this separates each individual color. So with this, we can tell the programs where to put each individual screen tone. So look, Shift A, look for mix, and put the red into the FAC. Now change the lower color to black. Now add with Shift D, duplicate this, but now add this mix to the upper one, to the upper image, and the gray color into the FAC, and turn this into a slight gray, just to see what is going on. This is not the final result. Again, duplicate image on this mix into the upper image, and the blue in the FAC, and lower the value of this just to see what's going on again. And now what we want to do is to put our screen tones in this part of the mix node. To do that, I recommend doing as follows. Shift A, look for image, and add your screen tone. I do something different I just don't add the screen tone as a whole, but as a 22 by 22 pixel image, and I will show you why. With this, you will see something weird happening if you connect it to the compositor node. You see, it's just a 22 by 22 pixels dot in the middle of the picture, right? But we don't want that. We want it to be in the whole image. So, what you're going to do is to add a translate node and add it to both axes. And you will see that now we have an image completely full of dots. And it doesn't matter how big or how small this image is, it's going to be filled with dots. So let's do the same with the next value, which is going to be 30%. So duplicate this one, open it, the 30% 22 by 22 pixel template, another translate, and add it. And you will see that now we have a darker looking screen tone. So now we're going to change the mixing mode from mix to multiply in this both in the last two nodes. And let's add the 10% to the second one and the 30% into the last one. As you can see, it has automatically filled all the places with the corresponding screen tone. And it did this automatically, and you can modify the looks of it by modifying the color ramp, which is the color mapping. Now you will see that you have little control over how much black value you have in your scene. It's really difficult to control it, you see? So to solve this and have a little bit more of flexibility, we're going to add a matte node, and we're going to change this to power. And with exponent of 0.7 should be good. Now if you change the color ramp, you will see that you have more flexibility. It is more easy to change. It's more smoother to change between points. So put the color ramp to which any looks you want, any equilibrium of values you wanted, and now we're going to add the edges to this screen tone. So let's add a mix, let's add a multiply, and put the edge into the lower part of the node. This will add the edges to the image. Now we can change how the color ramps for the edges looks like, so we can have more or less edges on the light. This depends on your style and what you want the final result to look like. It is pretty flexible, so don't worry about the looks, you can always tweak them and change them afterwards. But for now, we want them to look a little bit more intense, right? So we can do that by changing the normal enhancement, so you have a little bit more of detail. Or you can go inside the edge node and look for the thickness node and change it to 2. That looks a little bit better. Now you see that it has some gray anti-aliasing over here. I particularly don't like that, so what I do is add a matte node just after the invert, change it to greater than, so that way it just clamps the values and reduce the grayness anti-aliasing too. So this way it looks sharp and clean. Now, you will see that the what is supposed to be a transparent background is black. You can solve that by adding a set alpha, so shift A, loop, search, set alpha, and add the alpha in the alpha part of the node. So you see, and now it is transparent. So, how do we export this? It's simple. Go to image, save as, and save it wherever you want, like, you know, 007. Yes. And you will have your image export ready to use in your manga. Now, if you want to use this in any other file you have, any other scene, if you want to export this, just select all, Control G, and you will see that turns into a group. You can save this, you can save word this, and then exactly like we imported the edge node, you can import this node group to any other scene you like. So that way you can always just make your scene and then import this, and you don't have to do all this process again. Now I will leave a link to a file I made in my Patreon, so if you want to just go and download it and don't go throughout all this process, you can just go to my Patreon and download it. It's going to be there for you to use with CC0 license, so you don't need to credit or anything, and you can put this in any scene and it would give you a manga looking image. So, and this scene can be as complex as you want. It doesn't matter really much. The only thing you need to be careful about is the size of the image, because this process is a little bit RAM intensive. So if we go 2500 to 2500 and render, you will see that the RAM usage peaks significantly higher than before. But don't worry too much about it. It never surpasses the 3-4 gigabytes of RAM, so you should be pretty fine with it. So that was pretty much it. I hope you enjoyed this, I hope you used it in your manga or your comics, and make sure to check my Patreon and my YouTube channel so you can keep getting tutorials and more content to come. So thank you for watching, and bye bye.